This is the model of Casnub Bogie. Casnub Bogie is a bogie or a trolley which is used on the freight wagons of Indian Railways. I am rotating this bogie so that you can have a fair idea about how it looks like. Now I will be turning this bogie or the trolley upside down. Let's try to see what are the various components here. As we can see, we can see two side frames. This is a cast steel side frame on one side, and a similar cast steel side frame is there on the other side. This cast steel side frame is connected to the two wheel sets, that is wheel set number one here and wheel set number two here, through a rubber metal bonded component called the elastomeric pad. This is the elastomeric pad. This elastomeric pad is placed on an adapter called the modified adapter, and the modified adapter sits on the bearing, cartridge taper roller bearing, and the bearing is mounted on the axle. So this is a cast steel frame on one side and another frame on the other side. The connection between the two cast steel frames is through a loosely hung component called the bogie bolster. This component in the center, which you see, is the bogie bolster from here to here. This bogie bolster is placed on a fabricated steel plank called the lower spring beam or the lower spring plank. You see here, this is the lower spring plank or the lower spring beam. On the lower spring beam or the spring plank, we have multiple springs, helical springs placed on either side, this side as well as that side. As we can see here, there is a pair of three springs each in one line here, and another a 3x3 grid is there of the springs. The bogie bolster sits on the springs, and the springs are placed on the lower spring beam. Okay. Now let us try to understand how is the load transferred in the Casnub bogie. The Casnub bogie has two components on the right side and the left side. Here, this particular component I'm talking about, this is called the side bearer. The entire load of the coach comes on the side bearer. Earlier, we used to have metal bonded items which were the side bearers. However, the design was changed. Now this is a cylindrical section in which polyurethane rings are there, and which makes the side bearer. So the entire load of the coach will now come on the side bearer. From the side bearer, the load will get transferred to the bogie bolster. From the bogie bolster, the load will get transferred to the various types of springs. These springs are the springs of the secondary suspension, and some of the springs have an inner spring also. From this, the load gets transferred to the lower spring beam. From the lower spring beam, the load gets transferred to the cast steel frame. Once the load comes on the cast steel frame, this load gets finally comes on the primary suspension here. So it will first come on the modified elastomeric pads, which is a rubber metal bonded pad. From there, the load will come on the adapter, which is called the modified adapter. It can be a narrow jaw adapter or a wide jaw adapter based on the jaw of the this component. This adapter sits on a bearing, which is a cartridge taper roller bearing. The bearing is mounted on the axle, and then the end of the, there's an end cap is there in the bearing, and then there's a locking plate. Here locking nuts will come with washers. So this is how the load gets transferred. As far as the brake rigging is concerned, if you see, this bogie or trolley is what we call the Bmbs, bogie mounted brake system. Why it is called bogie mounted brake system? Because earlier the brake cylinder was installed on the wagon body. Nowadays, in the new wagons which are being manufactured, all the wagons are being the system is being changed from body mounted system to the bogie mounted system. Here we find that there is a brake cylinder here. This brake cylinder has a piston and a body. On either side, this brake cylinder is connected through bell crank levers with the primary brake beam. If you, let me just see if we can see the arrangement. So, one end of the body is connected to the bell crank lever through this pin. There is another pin here. We can see the pin. Let me bring it down. And then there is a connecting push rod. This push rod connects the primary brake beam with the secondary brake beam. Similar type of arrangement is there on the bell crank lever on the piston side also. This brake cylinder is connected to the brake pipe, and the brake pipe gets pressure from the compressor of the locomotive. So this is something very basic about the Casnub Bogie. Now, one of the most important component is the bogie bolster. This bogie bolster has a very different and a difficult geometry as well as construction. There are multiple lugs here in this bogie bolster, which prevent or which fix its movement in vertical as well as horizontal direction. To understand the bogie bolster, I'll open one of my 3D animation of the bogie bolster. You have to just go to the browser, write Yadvendu and B-O-G-I-E, bogie bolster Casnub. So you will find a link here. I'm opening the link. The link has opened. This is the detailed bogie bolster of a Casnub bogie. This is how it looks. Okay. When we see at the bottom, you will find 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. These are the locations where your secondary springs come. Okay. Now let us see the various types of lugs which are there. And the over a period of time, there's a friction between the bogie bolster and the side frame. So there are certain dimensions. In case the dimensions reduce because of friction, we have to weld a manganese liner here. So the first one, let us just have a look at this. We find there are two outcrops here. This is what we call the rotation stop lug. Let us see it again. This component is called the rotation stop lug. Now I think you can read it. Rotation stop lug. It prevents the bolster from rotating because of the rotation stop lug. The dimensions of the rotation stop lug is 518 mm up to 512 mm. Now let us see another component. One of the side of the rotation lug is called the outer jib, and in a high speed bogie it is 251 to 241 mm, that is the normal range. In NHS bogie, the range is 244 to 234 mm. Okay. Now, this particular portion is called the land surface lug, where the dimensions vary from 444 to 438. After 438, you have to apply a welder liner. This triangular section is the inner jib, and the dimensions can vary from 146 to 136. After 136, we have to weld a liner. This portion is called the pocket slope liner, where the nominal size is 8 mm, and in case the reduction in thickness is more than 3 mm, a liner has to be placed. So this is the inner jib, this is the outer jib, this is the land surface liner, this is the rotary stop lug, and this is the rotary stop lug other side. This is the portion where the center pivot top will come. The center pivot top, here we will have the center pivot bottom. Center pivot top will be placed on the underbelly of the coach. So this is the bogie bolster of the Casnub bogie in a very, very detail. Let's go back to the original. Where is that? Where is my I write here Vendu Casnub Bmbs. Okay. Let's wait for a second, let it load. This is the model which we were talking about. Now that you have seen the bogie bolster in detail, now you can appreciate the rotation lug, the inner jib, the outer jib, and all other components. So I will just repeat it for sake of repetition. Center pivot top, center pivot bottom, side bearer, primary brake beam, secondary brake beam, brake cylinder, bell crank lever, push rod, the primary springs in pairs, the cast steel frame, side frame, lower spring beam or lower spring plank, the modified adapter, elastomeric pad, bearing and plate and cover, locking plate, locking bolts, etc. So this is all from my side as far as the Casnub bogie basics is concerned. Kaisa laga batayega? Thank you.